Dear friends, welcome to lecture series in botany. Today, we are going to discuss the topic taxonomy and diversity of Fabaceae. In this lecture, following aspects of family Fabaceae will be discussed: taxonomy, systematic position, phylogeny, diversity, and economic importance. Now, first the taxonomy. Fabaceae is a well-known and important family among angiosperms. It's commonly known as bean or pea family. The name leguminosae for this family was first used by A. L. Dijsseu, derived from the characteristic type of fruit, legume or pod. This was followed by Bentham and Hooker. The name Fabaceae was first used by Lindley and is based on its type genus Faba. Faba is the Latin name for broad bean. However, the name leguminosae was retained because of its wide usage. Fabaceae is the third largest family in plant kingdom, surpassed in size only by orchid family with about 20,000 species and a sunflower family with about 24,000 species. While many genera in Fabaceae have over 100 species each, many others are monospecific. The largest genera are Astragalus with over 2,000 species, Acacia with over 900 species, Indigofera with more than 700 species, Crotalaria with 600 species, and Mimosa with 500 species. Now, the general characters of this family. First, the habit. They are annual or perennial herbs, shrubs, trees, or lianas with spines sometimes present. Root. Root is branched taproot, mostly with root nodules. Stem is aerial, weak, for example, Clytoria ternatia, or woody, for example, Dalbergia latifolia. Leaves are colline, alternate, dorsiventral, usually compound, pinnate, for example, Clytoria ternatia. Bipinnate, rarely palmate, sometimes simple or unifoliate, like in Crotalaria gentia, or bifoliate, as in Zornia diphylla, trifoliate in Medicago and Trifolium, or reduced to a tendril, for example, in leathrous species. Leaves are spirally arranged, stipulate, stipules sometimes spinose. They are foliaceous in leathrous. Leaf margins are entire or occasionally serrate. Leaflets are stipulate with reticulate venation. Both the leaves and leaflets often have wrinkled basal pulvini to permit nastic movements. For example, in Mimosa species. Now, the inflorescence. Inflorescence is a variable, typically bracteate, usually a raceme. For example, in Crotalaria viricosa, panicle in Dalbergia latifolia, axillary solitary in Clytoria ternatia. The flowers can also be aggregated in spikes or in heads. Now, the flower. Flowers are bracteate, bracteolate, pedicellate or sessile, complete, bisexual, sometimes unisexual, zygomorphic or actinomorphic, pentamerous, dichlamydous, with a hypanthium sometimes present. Carpel is a superior, single, hypogynous or perigynous. Now, a calyx. Sepals are 5, they can be 3 to 6, syncepalous or aposepalous, green. Estivation is valvate, odd sepal anterior in position. Now corolla, petals are 5, rarely 0, apopetalous or sympetalous, valvate or imbricate in bud, they are colored. Androecium, stamens 5 or 10 to infinity, free, are joined by their filaments in various ways, usually diadelphous, with 9 stamens fused to form a bundle and 10th stamen remaining free. For example, Clitoria ternatia, the odd stamen is posterior in position. Stamens are fused in 2 bundles of 5 each in Aschinamine aspera. Stamens are dimorphic in some species. Anthers are dithecous, basifixed, dehiscence longitudinal, rarely poricidal. Gynoecium, it's unicarpillary, ovary simple, superior, free, stipitate, unilocular, with nectaries often present in a ring at the base. Ovules bitegmic, anatropous or campylotropous. Their number ranges from 2 to many, present in 2 alternating rows on a single placenta. Placentation is marginal. Style is simple and bent, stigma 1, flattened or feathery. Now a pollination. Pollination is usually cross. It can be entomophilous. Self-pollination is present in leathrous and pisum species. Now fruit. Characteristically a one-chambered pod, typically dry and dehiscent along one or both sutures. Occasionally it can be a lobed. Indehiscent fruits like samara, drupe and achene are present in some species. Fruit is geocarpic and indehiscent in RHS hypogea. Seed, it's non-endospermic dicotyledons and shaped like kidney. Now the dispersal of these propagules, mostly autochorus, zucori in Prosopis flexuosa and Erythema ratum. Ballistic dispersal in Amphicarpia bracteata and Cytisus scoparius, Anemochori in Baptisia species. The Fabaceae are traditionally classified into 3 subfamilies, Caesalpinoidae, Mimosoidae and Phoboidae. Phoboidae is also known as Papilionoidae. Many authors have advocated raising these subfamilies to the level of family, some even treat them so. Now the Caesalpinoidae, it's a subfamily of Fabaceae. Flowers in this subfamily are generally zygomorphic with usually 5 or 10 free stamens. Staminodes are present in some species and a corolla which is imbricate in bud with typically 5 distinct petals. Sometimes reduced or lacking. The posterior median petal is inner to the 2 lateral petals. The next subfamily is Mimosoidae. Flowers are generally actinomorphic with a corolla which is typically of 5 free or basally fused petals which are valvate in bud. A hypanthium is sometimes present with usually numerous distinct or basally fused stamens. Now a Phoboidae, which is also known as a Papilionoidae. Leaves are usually pinnate, compound with a pulvinate base. Flowers are zygomorphic, sepals united with odd sepal anterior, corolla imbricate in bud, papilionaceous, that is, with 5 petals consisting of a large median, usually posterior petal called the standard, banner or vexillum, 2 lateral lanceolate and curved petals called wing petals or ali, and two anterior and distally fused innermost petals called keel petals or carina. All the petals have an attenuate base called the claw. The flowers are resupinate in some species like Clitoria, in which the banner is anterior in position. Stamens 10, usually diadelphous or monadelphous, carpal 1, ovary superior. Now the systematic position of Fabaceae. Fabaceae have been variously classified. We'll talk about some of the important classification systems. The first one is that proposed by two famous British botanists, Bentham and Hooker, in 1862-83. According to these workers, Fabaceae is placed in class Dicotyledons, subclass Polypetali, series Calceflori, order Rosales, family Leguminosae, Fabaceae, Sansolato. An American taxonomist, Arthur Cronquist, in 1988 proposed the following classification system for Fabaceae. Division Magnoliophyta, class Magnoliopsida, subclass Rosidae, order Fabales, family Fabaceae, Senso stricto, Papilionaceae. Erwin Takhtajan, a Russian taxonomist, in 1997 proposed following classifications for Fabaceae. Division Magnoliophyta, class Magnoliopsida, subclass Rosidae, superorder Fabaceae, order Fabales, family Fabaceae, Sansolato, Leguminosae. Rolf Dahlgren in 1989 proposed a classification system for Fabaceae, which is like a class Magnoliopsida, subclass Magnolidae, superorder Ruteni, order Fabales, family Fabaceae, Senso stricto, Papilionaceae. Now the next classification system is that proposed by an American taxonomist, Robert Thorne, 2003. According to him, Fabaceae is placed in class Angiospermae, subclass Rosidae, superorder Ruteni, order Rutales, family Fabaceae, Sansolato, Leguminosae. Angiosperm Phylogeny Group 2003, which is a large collaborative group of taxonomists led by Peter Stevens, classifies Fabaceae as follows: clade Eudicots, subclade Eurosidae, order Fabales, family Fabaceae, Sansolato, Leguminosae. Now we'll talk about phylogeny of Fabaceae. The recent update of tribal and generic classification of the Fabaceae has benefited from more than 10 years of intensive molecular phylogenetic studies. Attempts have been made to estimate the age of legumes and diversification in this family based on molecular sequence data. Family Leguminosae has been conventionally divided into three subfamilies, Mimosoidae, Caesalpinoidae and Faboidae, as stated earlier. The recognition of these three subfamilies is based on major morphological characters, especially floral characters. Differences in these characters led to the view that Mimosoidae and Papilionoidae or Faboidae are unique and distinct lineages in the family, which arose independently within a paraphyletic basal caesalpinoid assemblage. Recent molecular phylogenetic studies, for example by Doyle et al., Kajita et al., Wojciechowski and Wojciechowski et al., have also exerted strong support for monophyletic family that is more closely related to Polygalaceae, Suryanaceae and Quellaceae, which together form the order Fabales in the sense of angiosperm phylogeny group. Results from molecular as well as morphological studies support the monophyly of traditional subfamilies Mimosoidae and Papilionoidae nested within paraphyletic Caesalpinoidae. Recognition of a broadly circumscribed Fabaceae, including Mimosoidea and Caesalpinoidea, is thus supported by its monophyly. Now, something about nodule formation. Nodule formation is regarded as a hallmark of Fabaceae. Root nodules make Fabaceae a unique family. Fabaceae enter into symbiotic association with rhizobium species. This symbiosis culminates into formation of small tubercles on root known as root nodules. Nodules were earlier considered to be of a diagnostic value in taxonomic identification. However, not all the leguminous plants form root nodules, and neither is nodulation restricted to this family. Root nodules fix atmospheric nitrogen into plant usable forms. Now, diversity in Fabaceae. Fabaceae is incredibly diverse. This confounds generalization about almost every attribute. The overall range of variation in this family is higher than both in Asteraceae and Orchidaceae, as well as in grasses. The distribution of this family ranges from tropics and subtropics to lowland and alpine habitats. Aquatic species are also known in this family. The family includes tiny annual herbs, shrubs of all sizes and habits, lianas from annual twiners to woody behemoths such as Wisteria species. Flower type ranges from the reduced flowers as in Amorpha species to typical pea-like flowers and spectacular orchid-like flowers. Pollination is by bees, moths, butterflies, perching birds, hummingbirds and bats apart from selfing. There is a tremendous diversity of secondary compounds, particularly alkaloids, in this family. The shape of nodules is also variable, ranging from spherical, finger form, bifurcated, digitate and palmate to coralloid. Even the characteristic fruit type from which the family derives its name is variable and ranges from tiny single-seeded forms to woody pods which may be a meter in length. Fruit type is also variable, ranging from typically dehiscent pods to indehiscent samara, drupe and achenes. Winged fruits and articulated lobes with stick-tight dispersal strategies are also known in this family. Now, the economic importance of this family. In economic importance, this family is second only to grass family Poaceae. A large number of domesticated species harvested as crops for human and animal consumption, as well as for oils, fiber, fuel, fertilizers, timber, medicines, chemicals and horticultural varieties belong to this family. The family also includes condiment, dye and gum yielding plants. Fabaceae is the family of pulses, which are a major source of proteins. Pulses include Cajanus cajan, Cicer erichenium, Cyanopsis tetragonoloba, Dolichos biflorus, Lens culinaris, Fasciolus vulgaris, Vicia faba, Vicia radiatus. Species of this family used as fodder and green manure include Trifolium, Medicago, Vicia, Lupinus, Desmodium and Lespedeza. Fabaceae play an important role in terrestrial nitrogen cycle. They fix atmospheric dinitrogen into plant usable forms and make soil fertile. The family includes several species studied as genetic and genomic model systems. For example, Pisum, Medicago trinquetula and Lotus corniculatus. Use of leguminous plants as windbreaks, that's Prosopis, and a source of quercus, that's Acacia, is also known. Ornamental plants from Fabaceae include species of Clianthus, Clytoria, Bohinia, Cisalpinia, Mimosa, Leucania, and Acacia, etc. Condiments and flavoring plants include Ceratonia siliqua and Trigonella species. Oil-yielding plants are species of Arachis, Glycine, Acacia, etc. Some of the members are prominent sources of lumber and expensive woods. For example, Brazilian rosewood, Dalbergia nigra. Fiber yielding plants from Fabaceae include species of Crotalaria, Ebrus, Erythrinia, Cispania, Bohinia, Hardwickia, Fanera, Acacia, etc. Dye yielding plants from this family include species of Butea, Clytoria, Crotalaria, Indigofera, Cisalpinia, Hematoxylon, Albizia, and Acacia, etc. Gum yielding plants from this family are species of Astragalus, Cymopsis, Myrozylum, Bohinia, Ceratonia, and Acacia, etc. Timber yielding plants include species of Ascinomene, Dalbergia, Pterocarpus, Acrocarpus, Bohinia, Tamarindus, Acacia. Medicinal plants from this family are species of Ebrus, Arachis, Cymopsis, Lupinus, Trigonella, Cisalpinia, Cassia, Albizia, Acacia, Entada, and Prosopis, etc. Used in tanning industry, species of Bohinia, Fanera, Cisalpinia, Acacia, and Albizia, etc. are used in tanning industry as well. With this account of Fabaceae, I conclude this lecture and say thanks to you.